Welcome to the Uncommon Transformation Television Series.
One of the visions Governor Pabio had when he became governor in 2007 was to change the shape and content of Akwa Ibom State from a pedestrian state to a destination of choice and a business hub in the Gulf of Guinea. To achieve this lofty ambition, development of Akwa Ibom must be approached in a holistic manner, and one way to do this was to improve the tourism and hospitality industry. To this extent, he made sure that the Ibom Lomeridien Hotel and Golf Resort, which was started by his predecessor, was completed and made functional. It has an 18-hole golf course and it is one of the best in the world. Next, the governor invested in the Ibom Tropicana Entertainment Center, consisting of 6 cineplexes, a shopping mall, an event center still under construction, and the 250-bedroom 5-star hotel approaching its final lines. The state government, under the watch of Governor Pabio, also invested huge funds in the building of a 30,000-capacity stadium. This facility, among other things, will improve sports tourism in the state. A pointer in this direction is the fact that Nigeria's national team, the Super Eagles, have already played an AFCON qualifier in the stadium. All these have been driving and giving boost to the tourism sector in the state. The latest addition in the tourism and hospitality industry, the Akpabio-led administration will be adding to his already impressive chain, is the 4 points by Sheraton Hotel, under construction and nearing completion. This beautiful 14-story hotel, sitting atop a 13,700 square meters of land, located in Ikorekwene and designed like an eclipse shape, is already creating a buzz of other developmental activities in the state. This hotel will provide additional 144 rooms to the ones already existing in the state.
I assumed duties as governor of the state in 2007, and in my inaugural speech, I said, this is Governor Godswill Akpabio reporting for duty. Years after, the result is there for you to judge. If I say anything, people will say, oh, the governor is being boastful. But I give glory to God Almighty for leading us aright. And I also salute my team and all who have contributed in any way possible to making the uncommon transformation possible. Stakeholders who are not holding political positions have been there always advising us and trying to give us direction. And our youths have been very cooperative, because most of the jobs that are being done in the state, even the constructions, would not have been successful if there were disruptions and if the youths were distracting even the contractors. So I think what has happened in the state has been a success achieved through collective support, collective efforts of all. Every single Akwa Ibom child wanted it. And don't forget that this success started in 2006. In 2006, over 8,000 to 9,000 delegates were on the street for 5 days. And they shouted and said they wanted God's will to be done. And so when I emerged, I knew that God's will was done in Akwa Ibom State. And the will of God for man is progress. The will of God for man is not violence, is not kidnapping. The will of God for man is infrastructural enhancement. It's nothing but capacity building. It's nothing but fulfillment. The will of God is not hunger. The will of God is for you to be well fed and for you to look good. That's what God's will for you is, wellness. And that is what has happened in the state. Looking back, the glory must go to God. And I must salute the good people of Akwa Ibom State for their support, for their prayers.
Governor Akpabio, who was recently on a news magazine program on television, gave an insight into what to expect with regard to this project and others in the new year.
And within the former presence of the prisons, we used to have a prison right in the center of the town. We relocated the prison and took it further away from the town. That spot now remained empty because right in the center of town. So there we have produced a 4-star hotel, Sheraton by 4 Point, 12 stories.
Replacing
the prison. So Sheraton by 4 Point is up. We have reached the 12th floor, and then you see the Nigerian flag right on top. So we are doing the interior now. So that will also come up in general. In fact, I'm trying to struggle to make sure that those two hotels simultaneously come on stream before the match with Brazil. We have a major friendly with Brazil in Uyo International Stadium on 29th of March next year. So I want to make sure that those two hotels come on stream before the match. So within Ikorekpene, we are renovating the old Ikorekpene Stadium almost to at least a national standard. Mm-hmm. So that if a team is staying there, that team can even do their training. Yes, they can do their training and warm-up matches right there before they come to the nest of champions.
The site is huge. The work to be done, massive. Regardless of these challenges, the construction engineers from electricians, plumbers, tilers, welders and others are busy doing their work diligently to ensure that the commissioning timetable is maintained and the quality of work sustained in line with the deep standards Akwa Ibom people and Governor Akpabio are already known for.
Everything you've always wanted to know about Akwa Ibom State. The highlight of the uncommon transformation. Information about government ministries, departments and agencies, programs and policies of the state government. Multimedia resources about Akwa Ibom State. Political structure, the history, the geography, the economy, the people, the culture, the opportunities. Visit our rebranded website, www.akwaibomstate.gov.ng. Akwa Ibom State. Online. Real time. 24/7.
The Sheraton by 4 Point Hotel is coming complete with a retinue of facilities found in 4-star hotels globally. For instance, there is a swimming pool still under construction, and also a children's pool, a banquet hall or ballroom. It has 144 rooms, ample parking space with full accompaniment of beautiful landscaping in the making, and many more. The project manager, Renaissance Construction, Ono Comral, the builders of the hotel, sheds more light on the project.
This is a 4-star hotel. It's 13 stories, as you can see. We have 144 rooms, 2 presidential suites, 16 suites, normal suites. We have 500 people, we have a ballroom, and separately 3 meeting rooms, pool bar, spa, fitness center, outdoor and indoor restaurants, and a very nice lobby. I think the most beautiful place in this hotel is, probably you have seen that, the roof terrace and the club lounge is the unique point of this hotel, because you'll be in the highest point of Ikotekpene, and you can watch the beautiful view of Yucatecpene, the forest, the green, I can say. Total area, as I told you, 13,700 square meters.
How many?
13,700 square meters, the total gross floor area. The first concrete we poured for the foundation was 10th of April. So this is about an 8-month progress.
He commends government for the project, noting that it has created job opportunities for the locals, whom he says over 80% of them constitute the workforce on the project.
Their people, 80% of the workers here are local Nigerian workers. And we are doing this success with our local people. It's not the expat success, it's the local success. We have about 500 people now working on site, and 400 is local workforce, including our quality guys, including our masons, carpenters. All of our teams has local workforce, and I can say this is my 14th country that I'm working in, and I can say the best of the best of local labor force, local qualified people, the best is in Nigeria. I'm very surprised about that.
This place, it can help to develop the youth, as the youth can work here, have something doing as unlike before.
I love Abadio very well for this. And we are plumbing and we can see AC, everything.
The economic impact of this project in Akwa Ibom State is that, one, it will boost the economy of this senatorial district and also generate more revenues to the state.
This is the first time this kind of a project is coming down here in Akwa Ibom, in Ikoekwene. So what I can say in this project, this is a massive project infrastructure. This is a very wonderful infrastructure. We've never had this since we had a choir, since we were born. We've never seen this before. Even every day we come down here, some kids do watch from outside. I think this will really, really help the Akwaibomites. Thank you.
I think people will be coming from far and wide to visit the place. Like foreigners will be coming here to see the edifice too. And for us around living here, we are in fact benefiting already, because it provides a work for young people that are here, and a lot of people are working.
I see this hotel as a kind of a glamorous one indeed. Very sophisticated and admirable to be beheld by anyone who values ecstasy, aesthetic experience. And I believe whoever that value what tourism is, that knows what tourism is all about, and sees something like this would like to have an experience, even if it's one day.
Uncommon Transformation was curious about the eclipse shape of the hotel, what informed the shape, and also how maintenance will be done, considering the complexities of the building. The pace of work on this project is amazing. The entire work on this complex has been achieved in just about 8 months. This is due to the very latest technology adopted by the contractors, and also strict adherence to safety regulations and standards to ensure zero injury on site, which is not unusual with mega constructions of this magnitude.
We're managing safely. We have 5 guys here, 5 engineers. I'm from Turkey. My name is Ivan. And Engin, his supervisor from Turkey. And 3 Nigerian guys. They are very qualified guys. And first, we are giving safety induction training to everybody who is coming to site, first taking training. After going to site with PPE, we are supplying PPE for all visitors and all workers. Then another issue, we have a safety equipment for all works. We are looking every time Sometimes we are applying work permit for works. Then another issue, we will be celebrate on next month 1 million work hours lost time incident. Without lost time incident, we will be complete. And during the ceremony, we give small gift all workers.
The logic in the choice of this site for the hotel is worthy of mention. Ikotekwene is rooted deep in history as the first local government in British West Africa, and on this site was built a colonial prison, which the Apabi administration demolished and relocated to a more acceptable site. This replaces the penitentiary mentality which had lived with the people over the years.
Like the story of Ikotekwene and the town center, the first local government in West Africa changed there. Your story will change it differently.
Actually, it was established about 1919, one of the first establishments of the colonial administration. And it has passed through, you know, several years of, you know, development to come to this stage. But even at that, we can see that it is just reminding us of our colonial past. And actually, you know, the nature of the prison and all that it contained did not help the criminal justice system, that's the transformation of the lives of the inmates. So I want to really use this opportunity to thank His Excellency for taking a giant stride in building a new prison at Akwa Ibom State.
From the top of the penthouse, which is the highest point in the building, one can see a chunk of Ikotekwene from a bird's eye viewpoint. What you are seeing in your pictures right now is Ikotekwene Old Township Stadium, undergoing complete renovation. New terraces are being built. The main pitch is being regrassed to meet the standards in the new international stadium. The idea, according to Governor Akpabio, is to enable football teams that will lodge in the hotel to use the pitch for training before playing in the new stadium in Uyo. This facility fully complements the hotel. The site's chief of Renaissance Construction, Hakit Ozud, prefers answers about the hotel.
About the waste management, we will have a treatment center in this project. It means that we will convert the waste water to the, similar to rainwater. Do you understand? We will convert the sewage to the rainwater, sewage. And yes, this will be our the biggest facility in this project. Also, we will generate our electricity. We will have big generator, yes, of course. We will generate our own electricity. Then we will have swimming pool. And just in front of the swimming pool, we will have a pool bar. And additionally, this area will be our terrace. This will be open. We will not cover this.
The tourism and hospitality industry in Akwa Ibom State is set yet to receive another major boost as this hotel, known as Four Points by Sheraton, is expected to be commissioned early next year, 2015, by Governor Godswill Akpabio. Our Common Transformation recalls that Akwa Ibom International Stadium was commissioned just a couple of weeks ago, giving birth to sports tourism in the state. With the expected commissioning of this edifice to complement the five-star Tropicana Hotel in Uyo, the Akwa Ibom State Government under Governor Godswill Akpabio is a trailblazer in infrastructure revolution, setting standards difficult to match anywhere in Nigeria.
The quality of work being done in terms of strength and materials used in the construction is not in doubt, as explained by one of the civil engineers on site. He assures on Common Transmission and the patronizing public that all is well.
That is to make sure that we maintain a standard, specific standard that have been laid down by the consultant and the organization and the key players of this project. So we follow up work and make sure that all work done on site meets the creative specification of quality work. So in that aspect, we go further to make sure, ensure that all the material used on site, like sand, aggregates, and other caustic material that been used, have met some specific orientation that will be very beneficial for the management. For example, now if you want to cast the concrete on a site, it's my job to go around and check the work and make sure that the concrete production meet a specific standard so that the work done will be very good and recommended by the consultant.
As the hotel makes rapid progress, the rooms are also taking shape. While they are not 100% complete, sample rooms in the making gives would-be patrons a peep into what to expect when the job is completed. The shape, color, and size of rooms vary from floor to floor. The eclipse shape of the hotel gives the rooms a unique appearance. This hotel, just like many other high-profile constructions in Akwa Ibom, affords many young people job opportunities. This has turned their economic fortunes around, as many of them hitherto jobless before now have the opportunity to work and earn a living.
Creating this kind of thing here, or bringing this kind of thing here for us, I think it is an opportunity for we job seekers to, you know, to try and benefit here. By, you know, we work here, we have some experiences, the white man skills in terms of construction. At least I think good construction.
Yeah, we are making a lot. I say a lot. So now, very good. We are very proud of it. And we also thank God. We also thank what our governor has done to us. He's done a good thing to us. And he bring a little bit in here. So thank you.
Thank you. Yes, we appreciate for what our governor have done to empowerment of the community and the youth, because he have granted us an opportunity and ability for us to empower and put our efforts developing ourselves in this structural design.
You can see many people are happy. The project like this employed many boys, you know, takes them away from doing, brings them to the site in the morning.
What is the economic implication of this hotel on its immediate environment? The Bureau of Technical Matters and the Minister of Special Duties are the supervising ministries overseeing the construction. What is the commitment of the state government to leave a legacy to be proud of before winding down in 2015? As May 29, 2015 beckons for Governor Godswill Akpabio to vacate office as Governor of Akwa Ibom State, the people will be wishing that the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria gave room for a sitting governor to be elected for a third term in office. Reason is simple. Akwa Ibom people would have given Akpabio a resounding mandate to return as their governor, to continue with the unprecedented and uncommon development he has brought to bear on the state since he became governor in 2007. One sector of the economy in Akwa Ibom State that has seen tremendous improvement since he came into office is the tourism sector. With Governor Akpabio's resolve to print his name in gold before he leaves office by doing the needful for the people, the people will be yearning for a governor who shares his passion and style of development to take over from him. The people call it Uncommon Transformation.
Uncommon Transformation television series brings to you the latest information of the monumental achievements of the Governor Akpabio-led administration. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube to read the latest news, watch amazing videos, and listen to in-depth analyses and interviews with the men and women working hand-in-hand with stakeholders to make Akwa Ibom State better. You can also log on to our website, www.uncommontransformation.tv, for more information. Uncommon Transformation television series, bringing to you the right and current information when you need it. Welcome to the Uncommon Transformation Television Series.